Stay tuned today and learn about three different creative creations that you can make using the Illustrator Blend Tool. So the first of three really cool things you can make with the Blend Tool requires that you choose a color in the color palette. You're going to want to use a fill for this, and I'm going to go for a purple shade. So once you have your color ready, press L for the ellipse tool, and then hold down shift and click and drag to make a perfect circle. Now press V for the selection tool, and then hold down the alt option key and click and drag to duplicate the circle. Then resize this circle down somewhat and also change the color. You can then locate the Blend Tool in the toolbar here, or you can press W, which is the keyboard shortcut. All you need to do is to click one circle using the Blend Tool, and then hold down Shift and click the second circle. Your blend is going to be created, and that looks pretty neat. But what you can also do is to hold down the Alt Option key and then click the Blend and change the setting to something like specified steps. Now you can actually change how many steps are used between two circles, and this might be your desired effect. Or you could just go with smooth color like we used before. Now stay tuned, because we can actually edit this shape into really, really cool designs. We need to take the Add Anchor Point tool and then just add some anchor points along the path like I'm doing here. Once you have your points in place, press A for the Direct Selection tool, and then you can manipulate and move the points around. Now this could be used to make some really interesting designs, and you're going to notice that the blend kind of creates a shadow for itself as you move around the shape. But also what you might notice too is that even though I'm using the smooth color effect, my design has become kind of jagged. So what do we do about that? Well, press W for the blend tool, or find it in the toolbar, and then hold down the Alt Option key and click your blend. We can then use the specify step option, and we can include something like 400 steps, which will smoothen out the design. So yeah, that's the first blend in today's tutorial, but stay tuned for two more really cool uses for blend tool creations. So for the second design, I'm going to use the rectangle tool, so press M on your keyboard to access that, and then just click and drag to make a shape on your artboard. Now a really cool thing about the blend tool is that you can blend different shapes together. So now I've got a rectangle, let's generate a completely different shape. So in the shape tool menu, we can use the polygon tool, and just click once and drag, and then press the up and down arrows to change how many sides that you can use on your shape. I'm going to use a pentagon today to show you, and of course we need to change the color to make a really cool blend. Now bring the shape over the top of the other one. And then when you're ready, go and locate the blend tool, and like we did before, click both shapes whilst holding down shift. Now that's pretty neat, but let's go ahead and hold down the Alt Option key and then change the blend settings. So for this, I'm probably going to use a specify steps blend, and the lower I make it, the more obvious the steps are. But if you want to know a really cool thing that you can do with this design, is that you can press A for the direct selection tool, and then click on the inner shape, and then press V for the selection tool, and you can actually move it around, and the blend is going to move around with that too. You can also resize and rotate the original shape, and the blend is going to match with that. But you can actually blend three different shapes, like a rectangle, a pentagon, and a circle, and pretty much Illustrator is still going to blend everything together in a design. So have some fun with it, but stay tuned for the last blend tool creation, because it is really awesome. So before I showcase the last blend tool creation, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you want to keep learning and boosting your skills as a graphic designer. But yeah, the last blend tool function revolves around a stroke instead of a filled path. So select the stroke color in the color palette. And then go and find the curvature tool here. Now it's really easy to make some neat and some perfect curves with this tool, and just make some kind of cool design like I'm doing here. All is going to become clear very soon. So once you have the first shape, make a second shape below that is actually going to be a lot smaller than the original one. So once you have your shape ready, go and change the second shape's color in the color palette, because we do want to make that blend, remember, and it works best using two different colors. Also, of course, resize it down if you want to, and it does help if you have both shapes the same stroke weight. So I'm actually going to choose a kind of purple color to blend with my pink, almost ready color. Like we did before, go and select the blend tool, and then hold down shift to select both shapes at the same time to activate the blend. You can actually see the plus icon next to the blend tool when you're able to stroke. And of course you can actually edit your design by pressing A for the direct selection tool and moving the anchor points around. What you can also do is, like we did before in the video, hold down the Alt Option key with the blend tool and then change the amount of steps used. I think you can make some really cool artwork using this technique. And remember to like and share my content on social media to help this channel grow. Also, have yourself a great day, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.